Hello everybody, my name is Phythodas, welcome to this video. This is the bloody amazing build of mine. And this is the first time ever I'm coming into this Remnant of Great Chaos in Legendary difficulty, which is the endgame dungeon of Hades Act. And as we can see here from the Fog of War, I haven't been here before. It is going to be my first attempt to victory. And I also need to put the keys in the sockets. We haven't put any keys. I have the keys here, 1, 2, 3. So, we will see if this build can succeed without getting killed against the boss and in general in this dungeon. I tried to do the Egypt dungeon, it was going okay, but at some point I wasn't very careful and I got killed. So this character already has 2 deaths only. This character has finished the whole legendary difficulty and it got killed once from the Egypt dungeon because I wasn't careful enough. And once, I think, from Madikor boss, when I was going through the campaign, the special boss Madikor. But overall, this build is very awesome. It is very good with survivability. And the damage output is good enough. It is a build which deals lots of bleeding damage over time. So, we click here and we put one of the keys. We click here and we put the other key. Now, we are good to go. All of my skills are activated. Let's go and find out if we can do it successfully or not. I will also need to be a bit focused here. So here we go. Things will not be that easy probably because there will be many archers and whatnot, raged attackers in this dungeon. So, let's activate this one and let's do it. Yeah, I guess all I need to do is to hit them with my bleeding aura of my shield. This aura. Okay, they have deactivated my skills. I will have to activate them again. 1, 2, 3. Somehow. This build relies mostly on the bleeding damage over time. And the good news is that in this dungeon here we have many enemies that don't have immunities to bleeding damage. Of course, devices do not receive any bleeding damage. Okay. Let's apply some bleeding damage on the enemy. In this dungeon we will also need to remember not to forget to activate the levers to open up the paths. There are a couple of levers we have to activate. For example, this is a locked door we need to use to fight, reduce the lever to go through. Okay. And that guy just dropped this item. This legendary can drop only in this dungeon, endgame dungeon. Okay, we applied the damage on that thing, the flying object. And here we have the lever. Okay, let's go. Now, the boss of this dungeon will be very, very hard, very challenging. Actually, I don't need to kill all devices. I'm not going to destroy them all. It is a waste of time. But one day I will revisit the endgame dungeon of Egypt. And we will have one more video of that dungeon. One more attempt to complete it successfully. Now, I don't remember exactly the way. We will need to use one more lever. It is not here, okay. Forget that device. Put it on ice, the device. Somehow I lost my skills again because I lost my energy. Okay, still alive. I don't have enough energy potions, but I hope somehow that I will manage. Okay, here we go. Health potion. I prefer to get energy potions to drop. Still alive, but my potions, I need potions. You know, the bad thing is that we cannot get out of this dungeon by using a portal, go back to town to buy potions and then come to the dungeon through the portal. These dungeons are hardcore. Whoa! My shield! I just dropped my shield again, nice. But the shield I'm using is upgraded, this one. Which means that if I am... If I won't have any more potions very soon, then I will not be able to do it, to succeed in the dungeon. The liver is not here. Okay, I don't have potions. Die, please. Die and drop some potions. Energy potions, please. One energy potion is here. Nice. Any livers? No livers. No liver here. I'm trying to conserve my potions, but I cannot. One more potion. Not health potion. I have three. This thing also steals energy from enemies and it gives it back to me, so I was waiting for this one to refresh in this case. But, of course, it wasn't refreshing that fast. There would be a liver down here. Only one potion left. Only a single potion left. It requires 185, I have 120, I will wait a little bit. Can I do something, can I equip an item that would provide more energy? Yeah, energy. Energy points. Ha. Huh. Okay. Not a bad idea. I can put it there. For the energy points. Now activate this skill again. And if I change it, then we lose it because we don't have this one activated. Anyway. Now we have the skill ready and we have only one. Please, enemies, drop potions. They didn't drop any potions. I have only one left. Okay, so get the loot or go to the boss. Let's go continue forward to go to the boss. I forgot to buy energy potions in the beginning. There are let me wait for this one actually. To refresh. It refreshes. For the boss fight, I will need this one. To activate this one, I will need to have this available, and I will need this one as well. So I need energy. And we are good to go. It dropped a health potion. I needed energy potion. I'm not rushing. No need to. Come on, an energy potion, somebody please. Not health potion, the game. What are you doing? Ah, energy. Nice. I want to try to save this one energy potion for later, for the boss fight. Okay, it is some enemies here and some enemies here, then we'll go to the boss. This one is activated, I will need to go reach enemies that have energy, but this one. Okay. Now I'm out of energy potion. Wow, energy potion! I was out. One just dropped. Thank you. Thank you, very good enemies. Now, if I get one more energy potion, I will be a king. I had to use that potion. Energy potion on the floor! Whoa! Okay, so, the good news. The only enemy left for us to kill is the boss. Bad news. We will have to wait for this one to refresh because I have only one energy potion and I would like to have it in the boss fight. So, what do we do now? We change to the other weapon because it provides some energy points. We change back to this one. We activate this one. We could actually deactivate all the skills. Now it refreshes much faster. Yeah, okay, this is how you do it. You deactivate the skills that cost energy over time, constantly, I mean, and then you wait a little bit, it is going up, 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 very nice. And now we start activating skills. And we are good to go. Let's activate this one. Let's go. I hope I will not get killed because of energy potions. I will activate this one. I will use this one on the boss. I will use this one on the boss when I get to it. I will use this one to run to the boss. Let's go. Oh, yeah, zero energy potions, I did it. Wow, this boss actually could have killed me very easily. As we saw, my health was going down, but I used these things, potions, health potions, and I survived. And what did I get? I got the Dreamweaver's Crown, Philosophers of the Lynx, Respite, Stalwart, whatever, Thundering or Devouring. Only this endgame item. Yeah, overall the drops of the boss was very bad, but the good thing is that I survived, and it was a thrilling experience because of my potions throughout the whole dungeon. I had to be very careful of managing my potions, but I did it. Very interesting, nice. Okay, this boss can easily defeat this build, but if you are careful enough as I was, then you will probably survive against this boss with this build. So guys, this is it. Now, soon I hope I will go back to the endgame dungeon of Egypt to replay that one and record a video of that one again, and this time around to succeed. So this build is becoming very, very good, and it is only level 79. We could level up a little bit and increase some skills, maybe it make it a little bit better. Yes, we can. And also I could replace this one with something better. And I could also upgrade all legendary items of the build and make the build much better. So, great build. Thanks for watching this video, subscribe if you like what you see, more content is coming, and I will see you very soon. Have a great, super great day.